Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds, Peril on Gorgon. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and yeah, we're here and not at the... Was it the HIA? It's like right over here. HIA, yeah. But I sold a few things and I wanted to see if we can increase or tinker some items here at the workbench first. That's my hunting rifle. Oh, I'm going to modify it. Let's go repair first, actually. I like repairing each one at a time for some reason. Seems more realistic to me. Alright, so tinkering. I can't tinker that. I used this thing once, so I'm not going to bother with it. Insufficient bits for that. Yeah, I can increase one of their light assault rifles. The these things they don't really use that much. The melee weapons. This is at its limit. Too expensive at its limit. Or someone's helmet. You know what, so... I don't know whose this is. I'm in modify right now. It was the pristine light assault rifle. Is this probably Parvati's? Doesn't matter overly much. I can only improve one. So I will improve one. What's it go from? 158 to 164. Okay. It can go higher if I have the bits, but alas, I do not. Alright. So we can either run over there or just. Fast travel. If we fast travel, are we going to be right in the middle of these marauders? Because they came back once already. Alright, just get ready. Get sneaky ready. Because I don't know if they're going to be back again. But this is our next area. We just went to the chem lab last episode and then ended up all the way over here. Chem lab lower exterior. Here's the upper exterior. We had to go there to release... I had forgotten too. We had to release the lockdown. I forget what it was. I had forgotten what it was, but it's this building over here, which then leads up here. Synthesis and manufacturing, I believe. So the HIA, this is our second one that we have to go to release the lockdown. You have to go to two different buildings to release the lockdown. So chem lab and HIA. So here goes number two. They're back. I'll take a crack shot at the crack shot. I should have switched weapons, but I did not. So the stuff outside comes back, but the stuff inside containers does not. Unless I missed one. Which would mean it's not coming back, it just was never gathered. Spare tactical shotgun too. I had a feeling these guys would be back. Any more stuff laying out? I looted a leg. Well, that was odd. Okay. So now we have a way in here. Unlock with the pass key. I hate that noise. It's like something you'd hear in a horror movie. Dang. Oh, we just came through. Corporate recruit. Oh. What a sad fate for the corporate recruit. Vending machine, obviously. What am I tracking here? Reach the administrative level. You'll need to access Blakesley's terminal to send override authorization signal. That means making your way to her office on the administrative level. Optional, get inside the observation room. Can be accessed through a door in the test chambers. Okay. Observation room, 72 meters. Maintenance access. That way. And then we've also got something to find here. This is at the entrance. We already found that. Gorgon Mines. HIA observation room B. Okay, is that way. Oh, actually this one. We'll have to keep our eye out for that. Because I want to keep the other quest active. Picked up a few things. So I cut out some selling, and now I have more selling. Not much, though.
Show your boss that you are prime, because you take a dream of time.
No, don't do that. That'd be very bad for you. Oh, I've got a leak.
Whatever disgusting thing this is does not bode well.
Oh, Law. It reeks like death warmed over. I'm gonna hurl.
Don't hurl. Guess we have to go through that. What'd you guys see? Something gross? Is that not water then? Well, they're both almost equal amounts. Like, equal distances here. Oh. Baddie. That's a baddie. Two baddies.
My name is Dr. Marion Blixley, and I'd like to congratulate you all on volunteering for this important opportunity.
Whatever your past?
No, that as of today, each of you will be part of something greater. Together, we will unlock the path to discoveries.
Profit, all of us.
Of you.
Walk softly, Captain. Some of them still live here, and they hate to be disturbed.
I'd like to believe that nothing this place throws at us could be worse than what we've already faced, but I'm not so sure.
We made it through, Kem, okay? We can make it through this. Right?
Yeah, just see something, shoot it. Although, I was talking about they don't like to be disturbed. I'm feeling disturbed now. Oh, this is where we couldn't get through. Whatever it is right there. Salvage test subject.
Today.
Okay. So, not sure if the mysterious figure is trying to scare us just, or actually is proud on some level of the dastardly deeds they've accomplished. Not dastardly, it's truly horrible. So, that's barred. So we can't get in here. This leads back to that area. Yeah, that's the... Oh, this is barred. We're here, not here. So this is blocked off. And this. This is where we came through. I guess we could... If we could get through this door, which we can't, We go through here, hit that, that, and then we'll be able to get in here. But as it is, we can only go up here.
To congratulate you all on volunteering for this important opportunity. Whatever your past, don't know that as of today.
That's creeping me out, too.
Each of you will be part of something greater. Together, we will unlock the path to discoveries.
Profit.
Yeah, huh? Let's check this out. Human inquiry and auditing. Volunteer induction. Main menu. Please select from the following options. Incoming messages. From Marion Blakesley, subject safety protocols. To all personnel, subject safety guidelines. In order to maximize damage to... No, sorry. Minimize damage to company... property and or personnel, please observe the following guidelines during the volunteer induction process. 1. Do not touch and or handle test subjects. Please defer to security personnel. 2. Avoid using inflammatory phrases or terms such as untested chemicals. Consider patented spacer's choice formula. Test subject, consider valued volunteer. Cells, consider living quarters, these cells here. 3. Remind subjects that compliance is one of the requirements of their contract with Spacer's Choice. Oh, so they were a mandatory volunteer, I got it. 4. Do not interrupt official Spacer's Choice communications and or marketing while directing volunteers. Architect's balls, is that all of the guidelines? Look, these people are coming here from Tartarus. Don't let your guard down, don't get friendly, and don't get close. If everyone does their job right, these volunteers will leave this facility as free and upstanding citizens. Oh, that did not happen. Dr. Marion Blakesley, testing supervisor, Spacer's Choice Pharmaceuticals, Human Inquiry and Auditing. From Marion Blakesley, subject upcoming changes. In light of certain recent developments, our friends at OCI have generously provided us with advice and guidelines intended to ensure the best possible outcomes for our research here at Human Inquiry and Auditing. To that end, we will be establishing new testing parameters and volunteer preparation guidelines, effective immediately. These guidelines will be provided to you at your stations. I really would like to congratulate you all on what you've achieved so far. Keep your heads down and your mind focused on the work, and the rest will come easy. If you have any concerns, kindly forward them to my assistant, Benjamin Morley. And finally, from Benjamin Morley, subject re-question. So, from Benjamin Morley to C. Sonoda. Every volunteer means just that, Ms. Sonoda. We're entering a vital phase of the testing process, and that means every volunteer participates in the trials. It's all the more critical that we maintain careful records of the dosages involved, of course. We're counting on you for that. Benjamin Morley, Assistant Auditor. Okay, outgoing messages. To J. Weaver, subject help. From C. Sonoda. Weaver, have you seen my office keycard? If this is one of your little tests, it's not funny. Security is already at full burn. They're going to lose their bolts when they catch me taking the long way around to the faculty areas. Please tell me it's sitting on your desk or something. Callie Sonoda, volunteer handler.
I'll keep quiet.
This is another way back over here. Yeah. Can't let that borstwurst go to waste. Maintenance access. maintenance access. Well, that comes out there, I guess. Or does it just go in up in here? Supposed to be looking for an observation room. I guess that's through there. Okay. The phonograph thing's over here. Dead corporate recruit, another one. Open. Guess not. Wonder what these lights mean, if anything. Excuse me. Yeah, definitely looks like maintenance stuff. Over there? This place is seriously giving me the creeps. I think it's mostly my mind.
Volunteers? Must be somewhat like how I volunteered to serve at the penitentiary.
Yeah.
It's so homey, almost. Whatever brought these folks here, they were just people. Same as us.
Yeah, it's the second time she said something like that. Just people, just like us. Well, not anymore. Now there's something... has me not exactly scared, but... a little uneasy. Observation room that way, maintenance access that way. And yes, I see the red blip here. Welcome, volunteers.
This is your time to shine. You may just find yourselves doing similar work at a real office someday. Remember, compliance with all instructions from facility personnel is stipulated in the contract.
Just making sure that things aren't moving. My apologies, guys, if I'm taking this very slow. I am nervous about what's through there. there. Test subject. Hysterical test subject. I think it's built in my mind to be worse than it really is. I see you. It's slimy.
Everyone all right?
Doesn't sound like you're all right. All right, I'm not so worried anymore. They're just like marauder types. What was that last thing I picked up? It looked like a... It looked like one of these, only corroded. Maybe it was a helmet? I don't know. That's not real. Yeah. Savage test subject. All right, we'll check out everything that is to be checked out. What's the difference between a savage test subject and a hysterical test subject? I mean, besides the name, do they act differently? No, they just attack you the same way.